ADGS students and families, I just finished my lower body workout. I'm moving on to the upper body workout. Today we're gonna work our back, our chest, our shoulders, and our arms. Now in this video, I use a pull-up bar for one exercise. If you don't have a pull-up bar, you could just skip that one. But I also use dumbbells for four exercises. If you don't have dumbbells, grab something else around your house that has weight to it. Maybe a soup can, maybe a water bottle that's full, maybe a milk jug, just something that you can grab onto that has a little bit of weight. I'll also be recording a second upper body workout video that doesn't require any equipment at all, so you can also keep your eyes open for that one. Here we go, we're gonna start with a little warm up. We're just gonna do a jog in place. We're trying to get our heart rate up, trying to get our body warm, trying to get our body loose. Going to jump ropes in five, or jump ropes, jumping jacks in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, jumping jacks. If you want, you can turn your arms this way. Warms up your shoulders a little bit different. Getting our heart beating fast. Getting ready to go. All right, now it's an upper body workout. Let's focus on the upper body a little more. Arms out, fingers up. We're gonna do forward shoulder circles. Just little baby circles like you're washing windows. You should notice you're breathing a little harder. Let's go backwards. You should notice that your heart's beating a little faster, maybe you're getting a little warm and tired. That's good. All right, now point your fingers down. Make those circles big. Big circles. That's about 10, go the other way. You can shake them out a little bit. My shoulders are heating up. Hopefully yours are. We've got shoulder rotators. Hands up like this. Hands down. Nine, ten. Ooh, shake that out a little bit. All right, we got little pulses. Okay, we're gonna go straight arms. We're gonna bend our knees a little bit. Bend forward just a little bit at our hips. And we're gonna pulse these arms backwards like this, as far as we can. Here we go. Looks kind of funny, but it works. Let's do five more. 3, 2, 1. All right, I feel that right back here, getting my shoulders and arms warmed up. We got warmed up a little bit, just a little bit of light stretching here. Don't try to kill yourself. Just light if you've got a broom, a pole, a wooden dowel, a jump rope, something like that. Grab onto it. If you don't, just pretend. We're gonna go wide hands. Actually, I wish this was a little bit longer for me. Wide hands up and over. Here we go. Four, we're gonna do five. That seems like a good number. Five. Let's do one more. Even six. Six. All right, shoulder rolls. Two more light stretches, then we'll be ready. Take your fingers, push them down towards the ground, and then just drop your ear over towards your shoulder. Relax for 3, 2, 1. Roll it over. reach those fingers down. Here's three. If you're like this, doesn't do anything. Reach down. And I think this is our last one. I think that's six. All right, maybe a few shoulder circles here. A few circles here. Shake it out. Maybe hug yourself. And I feel good. I feel ready to start working out. So let's go. Welcome, boys and girls, to my personal garage gym. In this gym, I've got everything that I use and I need to stay fit and strong. Now, what I consider the basics are a pull-up bar and some dumbbells. A dumbbell is like this. If you don't have dumbbells, grab those soup cans, grab those milk jugs. Go out in your yard, find a rock you can hold on to. In this workout, we're gonna do exercises for our back, our chest, our shoulders, and our arms. Arms, biceps, triceps. We're gonna start with our back with pull-ups. Now, don't do your maximum amount right away. If you can do 10, maybe do 5 or 6 right now, because we're gonna do this a second time and hopefully a third time as well. So don't do your max. I'm gonna go for 10 though. Ready? Go. That was 10. We're not gonna waste any time. I'm gonna adjust the camera and we're gonna go right to our chest. That's gonna be push-ups. Now, personally, I like to hold on to dumbbells when I do my push-ups because it keeps my wrist straight. You can do them on the ground, doesn't matter. Make sure you're straight, you tuck your pelvis. This is good, this is bad. All right, you're gonna pick a number. Again, don't pick your maximum. If you can do 10, don't do 10 right now. Do like 5 or 6. I'm gonna do 20 right now, ready? In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Next body part is shoulders. So this one, you're gonna grab your dumbbells. Don't take something that's too heavy. If you're a young kid, maybe 3 pounds, maybe 5 pounds. That's okay. Maybe a milk jug, maybe a can of soup. If you're an older kid, maybe a middle schooler, if you have access, take like a 10 pounder, take a 15 pounder, maybe maximum. Okay, we're gonna turn sideways. 1 foot in front, 1 foot in back. Just a little stagger stance. Then we're gonna bring our dumbbells up to our shoulders. We're gonna do 8 of them. If it's too hard, your weight's too heavy. Ready? Pushing straight up. When you push up, breathe out. That was 8. Dumbbells can go down, so we did our back with pull-ups. We did our chest with push-ups. We did our shoulders with shoulder press. Now we're gonna do our biceps. You're gonna need dumbbells for this again. Now if you can't do 8, your weight is too heavy. If 8 is easy, do more. Ready? Same stagger stance, 1 foot in front, 1 foot in back. Knees are bent a little bit. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and go. Hey, one note about those when you do bicep curls. We're just working our arm right here, the rest of our body, not really moving. I'm not going like this and rocking my whole body. I'm not going and jumping or leaning or pushing to get the weight up. My body's still in calm and only my arms are bending right here at my elbows. All right. Last muscle group, triceps. That's the back of our arms. So we're gonna grab weight in just a second. Let me show you. We're gonna be in that stagger stance. 1 foot in front, 1 in back. Knees bent just a little bit. Now I don't wanna be upright like this. I want my hips to tilt forward a little bit. Head, tilt forward a little bit. My elbows are gonna go right by my sides. I'm gonna swing my arms back, back. Back with my dumbbells. Let's get them. Now you may notice I'm using a smaller weight. These are much harder than shoulder press and bicep curls. Smaller weight is better. Stagger stance. Hinge at your hips. Elbows up. Ready? And 3, 2, 1, and kick them back. 1, 2, 3. Elbows aren't moving. Weights are swinging back. 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, if that was too easy, do some extras. If it was too hard, your weight is too heavy. Choose a different weight or do less. Maybe you'll maybe do 5 or 6. Do what you can. Now we just finished our first round of exercises where we did every exercise one time. Now I want you to stop this video or go back and rewatch it so you can do all the exercises again for a second set and then again for a third set to complete your workout. Thanks for watching, boys and girls, and make sure to stay tuned because in part 3 of my workout series, we're going to be doing a core workout. Core is a midsection of our body, which is super important if we want to be healthy or if we want to be a great athlete.